I'm backing up my truck. I'm gonna hook it up. Loading up my boat with all my gear. I've been working hard all week, trying to make ends meet. Spending time wishing I was fishing. Well, Terry Wickstrom wants to take you fishing. Gather up your gear and come along. Well, Terry Wickstrom wants to take you fishing.
This is Terry Wickstrom. Join Karen Collum, Greg Collagio, and me as we take you to some of our favorite fishing spots from Colorado to Minnesota, the Arctic Circle to Central America and beyond. As we revisit episodes of Mountain States Fishing and Angling Adventures Television on the best of fishing with Terry Wickstrom.
Up here today. We're up in the middle of the Northwest Territory, right, Bob?
Yes, we are, yeah.
I'm with Bob Hutika.
Hutika, yes.
I said it right. I knew I was going to butcher his name, but I got it right.
Right on.
And we're up here at Tukto Lodge, and we're going to show you one of the greatest wilderness experiences in the world for lake trout and grayling fishing. We're going to fish a little bit with Bob, tell you about his lodge, his experience, what he has, and we're going to fish with one of your guides, and stay with us, and you're going to just see what a great time it is at Tukto Lodge in the Northwest Territories. Oh, there we got one, Bob.
It's a good one?
You know, I don't think it's a monster, but they're all good. You know that? They're all good.
They're all fighters.
Oh, I tell you what, I haven't caught a bad fish up here.
Want me to net them or just come
Yeah, I want you to go ahead and net them and we'll show them to the people. Oh. By the standards of this lake, Bob, that's just a small one.
That's a short lunch.
You that's need to, a short
you need,
lunch.
You need, to, you need to get to it if you don't have lunch.
Well, you know, we talk about catch and release, and you do let the big ones go, but you manage it in a way that you do keep a few, and you get to eat them at short lunch, but we're not close enough to noon. We're going to let that one go.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you, I'll tell you what, you talk about the size and quality of the fish. That was a tiny fish by the standards of up here. But yet, most people, if they've not used to fishing the Arctic experience for lake trout, don't understand that. You know, to a lot of people, that's a big fish.
Yeah, it is, and especially the numbers that you get here. I mean, you can do 40 to 60 fish per person per day when you're out fishing.
I know, it's just incredible. I'll tell you what, it's just the quality of the stay up here, the quality of the experience, and the fact that you catch fish all day long just makes it just pretty incredible.
Yeah, and the trout in this area are like, you can see that they're fat trout and they're fighters. They fight just as much as any pike will, and they twist and turn, and you've got a battle on your hands.
Oh yeah, I didn't have a real heavy rod here, and that trout had a bed over there, a nice solid rod in case we get into a big fish. But I tell you what, if you just want to fight a bunch of fish, have some fun.
Yeah.
But the thing is that at any time you could have a 40 pounder on.
Oh, that's for sure. And then even those 10s and 15 pound trout, I mean, they put up a battle, and especially if you get into the rapids and fish them in the river, and they get in that fast water. I mean, your arm gets tired after a while.
All right,
we're bringing them in.
Let's go back and get some more.
Okay, sounds great.
You know, Bob, we're up here in the rustic tundra of Northwest Territories, but the accommodations are pretty nice.
Yeah, they are. We got the new duplex cabin that's got individual showers and indoor plumbing, and it's very comfortable. It's all insulated, beautiful view of the lake, and especially with the new lodge that we have added now in the last couple of years, and it's just, the people are enjoying it with the view from the lodge, and it's a brand new facility, and it's just, people have a great time there in the evenings after fishing, telling stories and enjoying the atmosphere that we have there.
I'll tell you what, you got good, clean accommodations, showers, and great food. But if you want a more wilderness experience, you do have the out camps.
Yeah, the Dubonts, and they're comfortable. They got all brand new equipment in them. There's guides at each of the camps. There's a camp manager and cook, they're a little more rustic, but everything is very clean and tidy, but it's a different quality of fishing over there, and And people enjoy that also. And a lot of people are doing the spit trips, which is the 4 days on Dumont and the 4 days on Mosquito. And one of the reasons for that is that we don't have the grayling fishing over on Dumont, whereas as on Mosquito here, we have excellent grayling fishing in the rapids. So they go there and do the larger trout fishing over there, and then they come over to Mosquito and do the trout and the grayling. And it's a nice combination.
You know, Bob, another thing about the experience up here, it's very personalized. You don't have hundreds of people up here at a time.
That's right, yeah.
And, you know, so the people, like we were talking earlier, the people tend to mingle, they get to know each other, and then your group mingles with them. It's a real friendly, personable experience. And as far as the fishing experience, it's no more than two people per boat per guide.
That's right, yeah.
You know, sometimes there'll be one if there's an odd number, but you're talking about all this water, you can fish inside of the other boats, or you can make it a totally remote experience where you don't see another human being while you're fishing.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. Yeah, and then if it's a bit larger group, they all get together for shore lunch, if it's a group of six. And you know, a lot of times when you get groups of 10 and 12, they got the whole lodge to themselves, and it's a lot more personal, and they just, there's no one else there. And we don't want to take losing a dozen people at a time, and a lot of times we're going to have six people in camp, and very personal. And a lot of the people that have been coming up for years, they come back year after year. And
I'll tell you what, if you want to experience Arctic fishing at its best, you got to come to Tukto Lodge in the Northwest Territory. Oh, this is a nice fish. Nice fish.
It's a beauty.
Right, nice. Oh, there he goes. I want you folks to see this one. It's a nice fish. Not a giant for this lake, just a good, solid, nice. Oh, did we get him? I thought he swam right to the boat. The hook came out and he fell into the net. Awesome job.
There we go.
Let's get them a look at this fish. Good job with that net. Way to go.
Yeah.
Look at this. Here we go. this isn't even a giant. I want to get this one back in the water right away. But wow. Oh, thank you. Good job on that net. Nice solid fish.
Whoa,
man. I tell you what, you're catching fish, and you get that nice one. It's like, oh man, the adrenaline gets going again. It's just
wow. Your heart pumping a little bit.
What an incredible fishery. Here we are. You're looking out. It's this beautiful sunny day. We're up in the Northwest Territory. I could be wearing a short sleeve shirt. It's a beautiful day. We're looking out across the tundra. At any minute, we could see a musk ox or a caribou or a bear.
Yeah.
And catching one fish after another, life doesn't get a whole lot better than this, folks, let me tell you. Well, now we got to go get some more.
Yeah, that's true.
All right. Oh, nice fish. Come on up. Yeah, that's a nice fish. I got him. Go ahead and take the lure out. Woo! Tukto Lodge, Mosquito Lake, lake trout.
Here, I'll bring the net in.
Okay, I can get him right here, I think. I don't want him on that side, I want him on this side. Ah, he doesn't want me to hold him.
Here we go. How about that?
Tukto Lodge lake trout, Mosquito Lake, I'll tell you what. Arctic lake trout fishing. You can come up here and you can catch fish like this, and numbers of them. There we go. Oh, this is a pretty solid fish.
Yeah, looks like you got a nice one on.
Oh, I tell you what, the fishing here at Tukto on Mosquito Lake is just incredible. Oh, almost had him. Then we're out. I'll try to bring. Wait, I don't want him to wrap on the line. He's wrapping on the line. Can you get him?
Yeah,
go. Good job. Got him close to the boat and he started to take off. Didn't fight hard till he got close to the boat and they took off. Boy, that's a fat, healthy fish. Let's see if we get the lure out. Hold. Yeah. What's a nice, healthy, fat fish. Look at the belly on that thing. Man, I tell you what, let's get him back in the water.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
There he goes. Oh, I'll tell you what, that was, what do you think? I don't know, 10 pound fish?
Oh yeah,
easy. And 10. And that's an average fish. You catch 30 or 40 of those a day here.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Let's go, now we gotta get that 20 pounder.
That's right.
think he's bigger than you think.
Yeah, let's hope so. He's giving a good fight.
This is what happens, you let the guide fish with you, because you know he's helping, working so hard helping us produce a good TV show, and he catches a big fish. Oh, you pulled him over the net. You're too strong. That's a nice fish.
If I get you to hold that, I'll pop the hook out quick.
Okay,
just
hold
the net.
Nice fish. It's still not a giant, just a really nice fish. If you can get the net up, I'll pull them up and show the people that fish and we'll get them back in the water.
Sounds good to me.
Oh, he's got some weight to him. Just not a giant, just another great Tukto Lodge Mosquito Lake lake trout. We're gonna get it back in the water, so this one, when you decide to come up here and go fishing in the Arctic, this one will be here for you to catch, only about 5 pounds heavier. And there he goes, or she. Good job.
Thank you very much.
That was great. You know, Tim, we mentioned before, we're on Mosquito Lake here, and this is your main lodge.
Yes.
But you have several outlying camps. And what's the lake they're on?
That's Dubon Lake.
Dubon Lake. And it's actually, what, 4 times the size of this lake?
Pretty close, yeah. It's 90 miles from tip to tip.
Well, we actually sent one of our camera crew down to some one of the other camps for a while, and just so you could get a flavor for what the fishing and the accommodations were like at those places.
Lots of fun on this little rod.
Yeah, this one's getting up there. It's pretty long, he's not real fat.
Quite a battle on that light rod.
Little rod, for sure.
Fun. Great fighters, beautiful colors. Oh, nothing like Arctic trout. Boy, that's a nice fish, eh? Oh yeah, good job. Fight, Barb. Good job, Barb. Good job, guys. That's all we needed. Thank you.
boat anchored in these rapid lake areas between the lakes where the river kind of flows through from lake to lake. And all we're doing is making a 30-foot cast out into the current, letting it drift. And with a little beadhead nymph, and they're just all over it. Another nice fish. Boy, I tell you what, these fish are, look at the way they bend this fly rod. And they're so acrobatic. Wow. This is just... It's pretty close to the others. It's just strong, muscular. Look at the fin on these, how beautiful that is. That's what makes the grayling so famous, that big sailfish-like fin they have. Just, oh, they're so strong. I want to get them back in the water. I want to get them back in the water. They're just so, so strong. Beautiful, beautiful fish. This is a catch-and-release fishery for the grayling and the lake trout, except for a few lake trout to keep for shore lunch. Don't know if the regulations are that way, but that's the way the lodge manages it. And because of that, this fishing is going to be here just virtually forever. It's just unbelievable.
Another nice one. It's funny how each one has its own colors to it. Some have more blue and reds to it. Stop it. We'll get you up here.
It's time now for Terry's Tackle Tip of the Week.
All I'm doing is casting a beadhead nymph out into that current, maybe a 20 or 30 foot cast, and letting the current take it down, and it goes right past those feeding grayling. And once it swings, if I don't get a bite, then I just pick it up, make one back cast and one forward cast, and I'm out again. And that's all there is to it. What a great place if you're an inexperienced fly fisherman trying to learn fly fishing and to fight fish on a fly rod and learning what it feels like when they take a nymph.
That was Terry's Tackle Tip for this week. And now back to more angling adventures.
There he is, right there. And Tim's got one on the spinning rod. We got another double. Oh, and this is a beautiful one. This is a nice fish. Wow. Beautiful, beautiful fish. And Tim's is nice too. I tell you, oh wow. They're just so acrobatic. Tell you what, they're... Oh, look at that. We'll go back to that in a minute. Tim's got a beautiful fish over there, and this one is just an acrobat. Oh man. The bend they put in a 6-weight fly rod is just incredible. And you know what? You can fight them. If you lose one, that's okay, because there's going to be another one coming along in just a minute. They're so strong. Look at the bend they put in this fly rod. Wow. Oh, and this is a beautiful fish. Oh, come on. Can't get him in the net. Got him. Show him that one of yours, Tim. Oh, beautiful fish, Tim. Beautiful fish. Oh, that's an awesome, awesome, awesome grayling. That looks just fantastic. Yeah, go ahead. Get him back in the water. All right, we'll get this one back in the water. I'm going to get him wet here for a second. I tell you what, you get to the point where you can't keep up. We got our camera people turning in circles trying to keep up. Just two of us catching grayling. Just incredible. Get this up here and handle them very gently. And the fly is already out, so we just want to... I'm not even going to lift the fin on this one because they're so hard to hold, but just beautiful, beautiful fish. Catch 20 or 30 lake trout in the morning, stop for lunch, and then go catch 20 or 30 grayling. I mean, that's really a typical day of what you can do at Tukto Lodge in the Northwest Territory. Well, Bob, I'll tell you what, the fishing was great. You have an awesome fishery here. I'll tell you, it's as good a lake trout fish. I get to fish all over North America. And it's as good a lake trout fishing as I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah.
It's just really tremendous. And you got a great bunch of guides and a great bunch of people. And
well, thank you.
You run a great operation.
Thank you.
And I just can't tell you how much fun we've had. The accommodations were good, the food was good, but the best part was the fishing. And, you know, not even to mention the grayling.
Yeah, grayling, yes.
That may have been the best average in numbers of grayling I've ever seen in my life.
And we had awesome weather the past week also.
Yeah, I came up to the Arctic to fish in shirt sleeves. I'll tell you, that was pretty incredible.
Yeah, it was t-shirt weather.
I mean, if people can come up here, they can enjoy the lake trout fishing. It's just incredible. The grayling, see the animals migrate through, the caribou and the muskox. And I just can't think of I fish all over North America, and I can't think of a better place or better way to spend. If you want to enjoy Arctic fishing at its best, come up to Tukto Lodge. Get a hold of Bob at these numbers right here, this website, and we'll see you next week.